Hello everyone, this is the Introverted Positron, and thank you for once again joining me in the Completion Corner, where we are completing Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. So, we actually finished Alden Volcano last time. We're going through these areas really quickly. But before we go on to Lunaira Desert, which is what we're going to be focusing on for today's episode, we are going to head over to Farron Woods, because I believe in the Skyview Temple I missed a Harpy's Thing, which I've been talking about for a couple episodes now. So I'm guessing you're all bored, but that's okay. We're gonna go ahead in there. I mean, that's not okay. That's not okay at all. I don't know what I'm saying anymore. But anyway, the point is we're heading back to Skyview Temple for just a moment. We're not gonna be there long. I just missed a heart piece, so I'm gonna go pick that up, and then we're going to immediately return to Lunaira Desert, where we will look for the final dragon, which will take quite a bit of time. It'll probably take a couple episodes. And then it's going to unlock some things. We have a side quest that we need to get, actually a couple side quests we need to get done there. And then we're almost there, actually. In all honesty, we're quite close to the end of the game already, which has me a little scared, as in we'll probably finish it this or next week. In fact, definitely we're going to finish it this or next week, which I wasn't expecting. I mean, this game's fairly long, so I'm going to be spending about 30 hours in terms of trying to complete it, which, I mean, I thought this game was longer because I remember it taking me 40 hours the first time I played through it. Of course, I didn't know what I was doing when I played it, but, like, Twilight Princess, I believe originally only took me about 20 hours to beat. Of course, in my most recent run, it was a completion run on Hero Mode, so it took me about 30 hours to get all the Poes, to wait a night and all that stuff, to get all of them. And stuff like that. And that was fine. Like, I'm just surprised because I remember this game being like, I mean, it is the longest Zelda game, one of the longest Zelda games out there. I'm just surprised at how quickly we've gotten through it. And I already have a hero mode that I've almost already completed. I've already almost finished. So I'm gonna go do that afterwards, although I'm not gonna be showing that. Maybe I'll show the final boss fight, we'll see. But I mean, ultimately, what I really want to have is sort of the bonus for this is Breath of the Wild, although it's not really a bonus so much as another Let's Play. But that's kind of like where my focus is getting to that game and then doing stuff with that. I'm finishing this earlier, so until Breath of the Wild comes, even though it's not actually replacing anything on the channel, I will be finishing up Devil May Cry, is my decision on that. Because I started on the channel, I want to finish it on the channel. It's not work for me, it's, like, I wasn't sure about it because, that didn't work. Because I just did not really manage myself well with it. And then I lost track of it. And the fact is that my weekend schedule is going to be changing around. I'm going to be going back to doing two episodes in the weekend as well. So look forward to that, especially since it's going to be very different on the weekends. And that schedule will be somewhat consistent. I'm not sure about all of the details on that yet. Well, I'm going to have to see what I can do with it. Regardless, I have to kill this thing first. Okay, that's it. Just attack me. Attack! Come on! No, you want to. No? Okay. I'm just not really paying attention at this point. Okay. What? Oh. Seriously? Oh, I have to do a right swipe. Because of... that's not what I meant! What? Okay. Do that. Come on, Link. You can do it. There we go. Because that's where his full reach is, because the way his arm is. That's actually kind of cool. Alright. So, if I am not mistaken, which I don't believe I am, I could be. It's too bad I didn't check on this last time, but I believe there's a heart piece on the back side of all this. So, like, right, yeah, right there. There it is. So, I missed this a while back. And to be honest, I am not sure how to open it. that's gonna be kind of the fun of all this. It probably has to do with the beetle, because that was the item I got here. Also, it just makes sense. Thankfully, I can quickly search all these tunnels now. And I have increased stamina, so I can even search other places. We will see, though, ultimately. There it is. Oh, okay. Well, I mean, whatever. I know exactly where it is now. So it's not really an issue. Let's just head in. Ow. Stupid bat. Want to take me on? I got the Master Sword. You will not kill me. Okay. Okay, let's back up a little bit so I can kind of do this really simply and easily. And turn. Okay, that should open it. And then we never have to return to Farron Woods ever again. I can't believe I forgot about the fact that that was there. I think we're pretty much... we're done in Elden Volcano. I don't think there's anything left there. And apparently there's three harpies. That almost came out wrong. There's only three harp pieces left for it to be done with. That too. I think there's only three left. I keep on forgetting to check that, even though I keep on saying I'm going to. And I mean that. I'm going to check that because I need to. So that will happen soon. And we'll know for sure. But I think you can only get 8 hearts in this game because you start off... Like, I have to think about this for a second. And don't worry, I know I need to move forward. But there are... I'm pretty sure there are 24 heart pieces in the game. Since you need 4 heart pieces per, that means you get an additional 6 heart pieces. You start off the game with... I believe it's 4 hearts? Yeah, it's definitely 4 hearts. And there are 6 bosses, so that means... No, that doesn't make sense. No, you start off the game with 6 hearts. You start off with double, I think. So that means that with the 6 bosses, you get 12 hearts, and then with the 6 hearts from heart pieces, you'd get 18. So that would leave 2 missing spots, which I'm guessing you can fill with heart metals. So if I'm right about that, then that means that we actually only have the 3 heart pieces left, which makes sense considering how much we've already done and how much there honestly is left, which would mean that none of the goddess chests that we are going to be collecting in the future will have any, because I know where at least 2, well, maybe one of them will, but I know where at least 2 heart pieces are currently, and I know where possibly a third will be. But anyway, let's not worry about that for now. So let's, for the moment, we're gonna go and visit somebody before we head into the Lunar Desert. This will be a very short stop. But, nonetheless, we want to do it because we want to unlock the side quest before we go and head to the Lunar Desert. Because that will actually be our focus to start off, is completing that little side quest. The other thing we need to do is we need to start making sure to collect lots of rupees. Because we still need to collect the final heart metal, or life metal, I should say, from Beetle Shop. And we also need to get that bug metal. And I mean, that's pretty much it for rupees outside of one last minigame that costs rupees that we need to participate in, which is actually what this is related to. Because there's been this colorful island over here for pretty much the entirety of the game. There's just been this guy hanging out on it, who's a little creepy to be honest. But the point is that this is actually how we unlock the minigame on the fun island that he's created. And we're going to be doing that soon. That'll be right after we're done with Lunar Desert. This will be the focus. Yeah. Once we're 100% done with Lunar Desert. What am I going to do? It's no use. It's all over. What's wrong? You see, the party wheel that I pinned to my back flew off the island and fell down somewhere below the clouds. Without my party wheel, there's just no way I can make this island a place where people come to have fun. What can I do? It fell down below the clouds, so I guess I just should just give up on it. I'm gonna look for it, don't worry. How am I supposed to go get something that fell down below the clouds. That's impossible. Your dad's gonna be like, blah blah blah. Yes, yes, this is the last one anyway. And I know exactly where it is. In fact, we already found it a while ago. Actually, not that long ago. The other thing that we're gonna have to carefully do is we're gonna also get all the goddess cubes. So we'll be basically just dowsing the desert for them. I think we already have most of them. Which is a good thing, because I don't want to search a long time for goddess cubes, because that can really be kind of a pain. But I know exactly where we're heading off to. This is actually a pretty long area from what I remember. It's probably shorter than what I'm thinking of, but nonetheless, it's still probably the longest mission in terms of getting the song, or the part of the song of the hero. And it also unlocks something else very important, and that's actually going to be one of the other side quests. So if you know the game at all, you'll know what it is, and it's actually probably the hardest thing to do in this entire game. Which I know, well, it's saying something, because some parts of this game are quite difficult. Most of it's really easy, and to be honest, even the difficult portions aren't that difficult. But nonetheless, like, this is a challenge, and it's a good challenge. With the exception of having to redo some boss fights that we don't want to do, and I just kind of give it away. Yes, it's a boss rush. So that's going to be a focus that's probably going to last about an episode, because it's not short. We have to defeat every single boss we faced, and we're going to have to do it a couple times, because you can only stop at certain points to gain certain items, and one of those is a heart piece, and one of those is an item which I will not reveal for those who have yet to play the game. So... or to know about it. So we're gonna go get that, thankfully. And this is gonna be fun. You know, it's actually a fun challenge as long as I take things slowly. I just think about what I'm doing and I don't try to rush through anything. I'll be fine. And I know I just repeated myself like 3 times, but that's okay. That's okay. I have identified the item that the highly unusual man on the Fun Island says was lost. We can call the scrap shop robot to come and retrieve it. Would you like me to call the robot? Yes, please. Master, I will send more to the robot using telepathic transmission. Yes, yes. Is there any way for me to skip this? No. No skipping. You suck, game. You suck. Alright. Mr. Svi, Zerbt, you called? Whoa, Zerbt. This place seems strangely familiar. So you want me to carry this thing? Okay, okay. You just sit tight there and stay out of my way, Master Shortpants. Bzzzt. Okay. I'll be waiting for you in the sky, so don't take too long, Vert. Right. Okay. So that's done. Now we can look for Goddess Cubes, and, yeah, we can do stuff. Other things that don't involve that. Let's see. Oh wait, I don't have anything selected. I'm dowsing. Okay, so there's still stuff over there. And apparently over there. So let's go search around a little bit. There shouldn't be too many goddess cubes left here. Because I pretty well cleared it out the first couple times I was here. So, I mean, we'll see. We will most definitely see. Thankfully, at this point, I'm not worried about things. Ow. Like, oh, yeah. Right. I always forget that my sword is stronger. But we're not going to have to worry about certain things at this point. It's just, there really isn't tons to worry about anymore. Okay, apparently it's over there. So we're going to head over there. And believe me, I know this is a long way. It's just I need to be sure I'm not missing anything. Especially since if I haven't gotten it yet, it's probably because I missed it. Or it's in the area we're about to go to. In which case, that's a good thing. But we'll see. Alright. No, it looks like it's like right over there. Alright, it's a good thing that this is here. Okay. Yeah, I don't think that we're gonna find that this is going to be too difficult. We just have to, like, make sure that we don't miss anything. And I keep on repeating myself, I'm sorry. It's late again. That being said, I feel like I have a lot of more energy for this today. And I think it's because I've finally, like, come to peace with a lot of stuff to do with this. And in a very good way. And yeah, actually, no, I'm wrong. It's just going to be towards where we need to go, which is awesome. That makes things so easy. So, it makes me so happy. But yeah, I need to do this right now because I've been behind for a while now. And it has to do with a few things, as I've said before. I've had a little bit of a crazy period in terms of my job. My job has been crazy for the last couple weeks, and I was expecting it. But I didn't have a chance to prepare something because my life has also been a little nuts. Hey, over here. Is that you, Tip? Nice timing. I have been meaning to look for you. Come over here for a minute. I don't know why it slowed down like that. Okay, nothing over there. Alright, looks like we haven't missed anything. That's awesome. Okay, nice to see you, Tip. Say, you ever find that sacred flame you're looking for? Really? You did? Great. I was really curious about it, so spill all the details. I see, so after that adventuring, you finally found it. Tip, I have to say, you are pretty amazing. You're not the only one. I found out more about the legend of the three dragons. This news is going to blow your mind. I found out there is indeed a hidden area beyond here. There's a narrow path that I cannot fit through without losing a few pounds. My theory is that it probably linked to the home of the Thunder Dragon, one of the three dragons in the legend. And I am convinced that these robots must have something to do with it as well. The Thunder Dragon, a bunch of robots, and time shift stones. Yay, all my favorite things. What a story! It is pretty cool. Just gonna recharge the heart. Boop. I'm actually curious, if anybody is watching this who has played this before, is there anybody who didn't know about the fact that you can use the stools to recharge? Because I'm not sure if it's a well-known fact about this game. I don't even know if they... I don't remember them specifically telling you. It's just kind of a weird thing that I found out in my first playthrough by accident. which was kind of fun. And it's kind of a fun little thing just because it makes it very easy to recharge at points, especially since hearts in this game don't show up as often as they do in a lot of other games, which is a good thing. I know there were heart plants, but still, like, there's quite a few opportunities to have hearts where there just are none, and that's fine. That's actually a good thing. So the stools were kind of a nice addition just to kind of balance things out. And for that, I am actually very thankful. Because without them, it would be an annoyance to do all this stuff. Okay. I don't mind the rupees. Ah, not... It's that few rupees, though. Apparently, I just need to play, like, a couple more notes. Alright. Boing! Ah, it's a monster claw. But yeah, so I'm curious to see, like, how many people just didn't know about that before they saw this Let's Play. I'm honestly curious, because it's not something that you really need to know, and I don't remember it ever being told to you. So yeah, if you didn't know, let me know. I did not know that was in this game. That's a reference to Ocarina of Time, and I believe Majora's Mask as well. That is great. I love it. Alright. We're outside now. This is Lanera Gorge. Legends tells of a dragon loyal to the goddess living in this area. Lanera Gorge. We are here. We're going so far, we're being somewhere. I don't know what I'm saying, because it doesn't rhyme anymore. Okay. Consequently, the terrain is intricately subdivided with remnants of long abandoned mining equipment such as minecarts and their tracks. Perfect. Alright. Thank you.
Cool, cool.
Alright. Well, let's head in then. So as you can see, there's a big pile of bones right over there. And that is actually an issue. And quite a big issue, because this quite clearly looks like a dragon. Talk. Dot dot dot. Apparently its spirit still lives on. That must suck. Yeah, this guy is pretty big. So yeah, the dragon's dead. So, whoops. I don't think there's a lot we can do about that at the moment. At least not without using a beetle. Oh yeah, we're good. And as for over here, there's honestly not a lot we can do about that. Anyway, I know exactly what we need to do. I actually remember this part pretty clearly because this is actually the last thing I did when I played it. There was actually, when I did hero mode, there was a bit of a gap between when I started and when I continued it. I also wanted to show my cousin this game because he didn't have a Wii and I was curious to see if he'd like the game. He did. In fact, he got his own copy. And yeah, he enjoyed it. I don't think he ever beat it, but he's just not somebody who, you know, beats a ton of games. Which is fine. Not everybody's an avid gamer. But, you know, he still enjoys a lot of video games. Anyway, I'm not going to get into telling stories about my cousins. Because that could go for a very long time. I have lots of cousins. Because my family's pretty large. It's something I'll say. I have a pretty large family. And hi. Yeah. Oh yeah, there it is. Right. This part has actually had me stuck for a little while before. But there's a key just over here. So yeah, I remember this part because there was a gap of time. I think it was like 6 months between when I started playing hero mode and when I took a break. And then I started playing it again and he was here. And then I stopped playing after that again. And I'll complete it later because it's right there. So I might as well complete the game and actually like complete the game in both modes, which is awesome, especially since I'm so close in that mode already. There's probably some goddess cubes that I missed there, but those will only take me a few minutes to find. And yeah, I'm really excited for it. And I'll have completed every single 3D Zelda game with exception of Breath of the Wild, which I am planning on completing, and it's gonna take me a very long time. And this time I'll do it without, like, taking a huge break from the game. Yeah. So, in case you didn't notice, exactly what this do is this. And it's a minecart, which is also important. This is actually a really long track. And it's kind of a cool one, too. What do you want to say? There are lots of big time shift stones here, Zert. Did you get permission from Master Thunder Dragon to come here like we did? Verm. We were just about to transport this time shift stone to Master Thunder Dragon. Weep! In other words, if I follow that, I'll get there. There are many monsters, Verm. Practice extreme caution, Berserk. I hate the fact that it doesn't finish before that happens to him. Switch it, and let's continue. Yeah, this is a long track. Like, this, I remember this being, like, really long. Ow. Okay, whatever. I don't actually finish it. Perfect. Okay. And yeah, we're gonna see lots of stuff like this. But the idea is just to keep up with it because you don't want to fall into the hazards that are in the present, mostly. And you also don't want to die to the hazards that are obviously in the past. But yeah, it's really cool. Like, I know that this mechanic is used a lot in the game, and I can guarantee that there are complaints about it. But I love this mechanic. I think it is just such a cool and, like, almost like limitless idea. And I'm just going to ignore you. Really not needed, guys. Really not needed. Yeah. Good job. Alright, and up we go. And yeah, it's just, I honestly love it. And we're almost done with it, because there's not going to be that many more time shift students to come. But it makes me really curious, because, I would be surprised if Breath of the Wild did not have, some kind of time mechanic to it. Because every single 3D Zelda game has some kind of time mechanic to it. Or at least in some weird form. Even Wind Waker did, although it's a little bit more subtle. Because Ocarina of Time, of course, was obvious. You had the Song of Time and the travel between the past and the future. Thanks for that, you stupid Dekababa. Wind Waker, again, Majora's Mask, obviously, again, you could travel backwards. You could travel back in time through the 3 days. You could go down time. In a lot of ways, it was the one that actually had the most time mechanics. You could also speed up time and go forwards in time. All of it was possible, really. Although, I guess you couldn't just speed up time. That was never really anything. But yeah, so it's interesting in that way. And then Wind Waker was the one that was kind of almost an outlier in a way. It was the more subtle one in the fact that the only time travel was the preservation of Hyrule. Like, the kingdom itself was preserved in a time bubble of sorts. And when you arrive in the castle, like, everything is suspended in time. So the 3D Zelda games have always had that theme, and then this one, like, we're seeing the time mechanic right now. The time shift stones, and also the Gate of Time, which is a really important story. Yeah, I'm gonna wait for that to go. So yeah. Twilight Princess. Twilight Princess wasn't as big, but there was some travel back in... you did travel back in time to get to the Temple of Time, which was really cool also. So yeah, every single 3D Zelda game has had time travel mechanics of some sort. Not every single Zelda game has. I mean, they usually have some kind of... point where they talk about something to do with, like, traveling to another world or something, which I think encompasses a lot of Zelda games. But yeah, the point is that every single 3D Zelda game has had time travel in it, so I kind of am expecting Breath of the Wild to also hold that particular tradition. I know it's trying to change up Zelda, but we're talking more about mechanics than we are about mechanics and layouts rather than common themes, because it's still about an adventurer, a hero who is still, is saving a princess, but in this case, it seems like a princess who's actually very independent, and is trying very hard to save her kingdom, and it looks really, really cool. The important part is that the goddess Hylia is also involved. Because, as I've said before, Hylia is a goddess of time. So, if that's true, then if Hylia is involved in the game, then that means two things. One, it's somehow connected to this game. It doesn't mean that it has to take place near it. But it's somehow directly connected to Skyward Sword, which is very interesting. Because we have not seen any references to Hylia in any other game. So the fact that it's popping up now is incredibly important. And it might even mean something like in the particular timeline where it takes place, it might be the final part of the cycle or something like that. Or maybe not. I'm curious. Which would mean that the games wouldn't have to end for that timeline. It would just mean things. But I don't actually necessarily believe that. I think at this point, I'm in a weird position, not because there's no evidence really completely disproving this, but there's no evidence really well, there is evidence actually supporting it. But I'd have to get into a long thing about it, and I'm not a theory kid. I just find these theories really interesting. And that's that. I, at this point, I'm pretty much like convinced that it actually takes place between Majora's Mask and Twilight Princess, which I know sounds ridiculous. Like, I thought the same thing, but then I looked into it more with people who were doing theories and did analysis on things that were important to the games, and it seems incredibly completely honest. And I'm going to be very interested to see if that's true, because if it is, it's going to be interesting. I would love to see a game in the, like, and I know what people are saying, the downfall timeline, but I don't believe it can be the downfall timeline at this point. And the main reason I'm saying that is because the architecture makes no sense, which I know isn't something that's been consistent between Zelda games. But at the same time, there are things that should be consistent that wouldn't be if that was the case. And placement makes sense in that point, because there is no castle town in that timeline. And yet, in this game, there's two castle towns. There's the one from Twilight Princess, and there's one from Ocarina of Time. And then there's also the fact that the Zoras aren't the green Zoras that we know from the Downfall timeline that are in pretty much all of the games. Which I know that if it's early in the timeline, they just might not exist yet. But, you know, I have my doubts on that one. Okay, just survive, just survive. Anyway, and a lot of you are probably going to disagree with me on that, and that's fine. I'm actually really curious to see where you think where it is, because I think it's a really cool question right now. And there's no, like, perfect answer. I think that because there's some very specific evidence from, like, recent games that have been remade especially, that seem to highly indicate that. And I think that at the very least it's going to be in the child timeline. That's, from Process of Elimination, that seems like it's going to be the case. It's weird that I'm talking about these things, but so many other people are talking about it. And I have not done the serious analysis of these things that I have. Not that being said, I've heard a lot of their analysis of it. And anyway, this is, again, this isn't a theory. So I'm going to get off the topic. I just find it really cool. It's just so much fun to speculate. It's just, it has to be kept in mind that that's what it is. It's speculation, and we're not going to know until the game's released. Which will be a good day indeed. Yeah, everything respawns. That is so annoying. I'm looking forward to the game. I'm looking forward to figuring out where it places in the timeline, because I know a lot of people don't think it's important because Nintendo hasn't really kept consistent with it, and the timeline's still pretty recent thing at this point. But that's exactly what it is that the timeline is an incredibly recent thing. And I think it was released for very specific reasons. And the fact is, in between Skyward Sword and Breath of the Wild, I think is really important. I think it's an indication of where we're going with all of this. And that it's going to play in a full Earth control, and this sucks where I am. This is the part I always remember about this place, and I never liked it. Especially in Hero Mode. I hated this in Hero Mode. So happy I'm already done this in Hero Mode. We're gonna have fun discussing that when the game actually comes out, because we'll be discussing a lot of story elements. I will almost for sure be doing a philosophy video of it. In fact, I will be doing a philosophy video for this game. When these come out, I'm not sure. I have what I want to do, and then I have a completely different issue where it very well might just not turn out the way I want it to, which is something I have to consider, because I don't know that much about editing. I'm going to be learning a lot of it in the next couple months. In fact, in the next couple weeks. And it's going to be fun. No! Let me in, please. I did not know I could get locked out like that. Oh wait, I could have just opened it up. And now we have to do this again. I don't even care. This place just sucks. Or I both die. Okay, let's just do this. I have 4 fairies, we're good. Okay. That is more like it. What? Oh. I thought I stabbed it. Okay. I'm just being dumb. Well, it's a good thing I have 3 fairies. That was so bad. Alright. Done. Okay. And done. Okay, you know what? I'm not playing. Let's just do this. Done. No, you're actually not even paying attention to me at the moment. Alright, and let's do this as quickly as possible so we never have to worry about this room ever again. Okay, and run through the door immediately. Perfect. Okay, and we're back here. So we're pretty much done now, which is awesome news. We're going to have to deal with the occasional block in the path at this point, but ultimately it's pretty minor. Right. Okay. So, of course, we just need to use the... yeah, I already see it. So all we... Oop, that was bad. All we need to do is simply grab one of these bombs, and then we make our way up there. That's simple. And then we're done. Alright. Alright. There we go. And that's a goddess cube over there. I think that's the last goddess cube in like the entire game. Yeah, those are probably gonna... Okay, just wait for it. We know how to deal with our Deku Baba here. Alright, and we are back. Fantastic. So that side, that particular side mission's not side mission, that particular part of this is done. So we're actually like pretty much there. All we have to do is create a situation where the dragon is not dead, which is easier said than done. But it's not that hard actually. I know exactly what happens here because this is one of the kind of more interesting parts of the game. Like it takes some weird time travel mechanics. Okay, Thunder Dragon, I'm coming. Cough, cough. Apparently going with that. Oh, hello. I haven't had a visitor like you here in quite a while. You're a human, aren't you? You have some reason for coming this far. What is it? I see. So you're a tip from the sky, cough. That's not much of a name, is it? How about I add a model number to your name, like my friends have got? Maybe LDT tip 16. LD. Oh, I can tell you don't like the sound of that. That's a shame. Cough, cough. So what can I do for you? Oh, you say you need me to teach you a song. Was this the 16th game in the series? I bet it is. Legend tip 16 or something like that. I think it is, actually, now that I'm thinking about it. Oh, you say you need me to teach you a song? Cough. Hold on now. Didn't you just say you came from the sky tip? So you're the hero chosen by the goddess, aren't you? I see. Well, that is something. Although, I must apologize, you see. I can't really help you. I may have enough strength for a brief chat like this, but... Well, as you can see, I am quite ill. Cough. I'm in no shape to sing. I did think it was the goddess herself who entrusted me with this important duty. I feel the deepest shame. Cough. Okay. Let's get you fixed up. Okay. Yes, yes. It's actually pretty simple what we need to do. Oh, shoot. I just realized something. Okay, we need to go do that side quest first, actually. So let's go quickly do that side quest, and then we'll be right back here. Because we actually, I believe, need Scrapper for this. So let's go do this first. We'll drop off this, and then we'll come back. But yeah, we should be able to get the final part of the song before we're done. And next episode, we'll probably be focused on getting the minigame done. Which I'm looking forward to. I actually really like doing boss rushes. I mean, in Mario Galaxy, it's really easy. I had almost no issues. I think I died a couple times the first time, but then after that, no sweat. It was really just remembering how to beat one boss in particular. It was the block boss. But I mean, PD Piranha, never difficult. Either game. it was fun. You know, it's cool to see bosses that had been in the first game kind of all grouped into that. And it wasn't all of them. I mean, there's Mega Leg, Bowser, of course. At least the Bowser version from Mario Galaxy 1, which was... I liked it more in a lot of ways, actually. But anyway, I'm not here to talk about Mario Galaxy. This might be a Nintendo game, but Nintendo games are all very different. Okay. Here's your wheel thing. Perfect. If you want something else, let me know. Is this? It is! Yahoo-fee! My party wheel! Thank you so much. Now I can realize my dream of opening Fun Fine Island. I'm so happy. And I'll let you be my first customer, young man. Thank you so much. It's going to be so much fun. Okay. I don't think it's available immediately, but we might as well check. It's not going to hurt. Alright. So now we're at 70. There's only 10 left. Okay. Okay, so yeah, we can play now. First you need to know is you'll be shot out of a cannon, you'll fly way up there, don't cry. Right, so what we need to do, and this is the hard part, is I need to land in a specific place to get a heart piece. So we're going to be trying this probably for a while. I wasn't planning on doing this episode, but we're already here, so we might as well just get it done. That way we never have to come back here. Oh, and I can't use my silk off.
Yahoo!
No, it's okay.
Yes!
Okay, so this is going to require me to have, like, good control over where I'm landing. Which is not easy. So let's just get in here. Let's do this. And in all honesty, I never have done this before, so let's have fun with it. Oopsies. I have no idea what all this does for us. Yay! Oh, okay, I see. So I think all that we need to do is we just need to land on the colored space. But it's not hard. I mean, it is hard. Why did I say it's not hard? Anyway, if we run out of rupees, we'll definitely not continue doing this. We'll see. Okay, so we want to pass through the rings. We don't want to hit the balloons, so that's good to know. I wasn't really paying attention to all of his rules, to be honest. So I was learning a lot of it on the fly there. But that's alright. So now we're gonna do it. I just don't know how to time the whole thing. So let's aim. I also wonder if this like slows down the wheel or something. Because if it does that, then that makes my life way easier. Okay, that was bad. And if you hit one balloon, it looks like it like... Oh, no, and we landed on zero. okay. Yeah, in all honesty, it's not that bad. It's going to take a while for me to get the timing down because the wheel is just... Taking into account the spinning of the wheel with your fall speed is not very easy. So we're really gonna have to make sure we're aiming properly, or we're just not gonna do it. And I love the fact that you're using like a cannon from Mario 64. I mean, it's not the same coloring, but it's like pops up out of the hole and all that stuff. Okay. Right. So. Dude. Okay. I get it. Don't hit them. At least I believe that all we need to do is hit that marker. For all I know, this is just for rupees and wasting my time, so I should probably check that. Okay, so I think where we want to be right... Aww. Not there. I was aiming too much for it. So I think where I need to make sure I'm landing is when I'm tracking it, I need to aim slightly differently. Because I need to figure out where I'm going to land when it's, like, where I need to hit it in terms of rotation. So I need to figure out how many rotations it's making based on my distance. Which, in all honesty, if I really wanted to concentrate, I guess it wouldn't be impossible. But it's a really hard thing to do. But that colorful square is the one I'm aiming for. So we're going to see if I can hit it. But yeah, you can probably see why I gave up on this. This is a little ridiculous. This is so bad. Okay, so I believe... No. Okay. Give me 1 second. No. So, if I actually look this up, which I'm going to, because I want to make sure that I'm not, like, doing something that I shouldn't be. Right. So, what I want to do is figure this out so I don't have to do this ever again. Okay, so, right, not what I meant to do. I found the side quest, I just didn't, so I want to actually do this because this is an annoying thing to do. So let's see if there's some kind of trick for it. Thank you. Okay, so apparently it does slow down for each one that we hit. Wait, maybe this doesn't give you a heartbeat. Alright, well, let's see in a second. Oh boy. Okay, so I'm actually wrong. What we need to do is we need to hit all 5 rings, not hit the balloons, and then also hit the 50 rupee space. So basically, it's not impossible, but it's going to be very, very difficult. Okay, so I need to get better at this, otherwise this just isn't going to work. So let's do this. Okay, let's actually concentrate. Because I've been doing this pretty relaxed until now. Let's just make our way through the rings. Okay, don't hit the balloons. Because basically what you need to get the heart pieces is your times 10 multiplier, and then you... Oh, wow. But then you also have to get all the rings. So let's practice getting the rings and doing this. So once we mastered one, we should be... Oh, okay. I could deal with that. Although I think, yeah, we hit the green one, of course. All right, this is going to be... Oh, boy. But at least we got 6 rupees. So, you know what? We only spent 14 rupees on that particular game. Okay. So we're going to be here a while, in all honesty. This is not an easy game. And it's hard for me to judge exactly where I need to go in order to get to the space that I want. You know, not to mention it's all a combination of controlling my fall speed as well as that. So, if I can do this, and I will do this, guaranteed. If it starts going over the hour mark, then I'll just skip to when I complete it. But it looks like we're gonna be stopping pretty much right after this game. But let's see. Okay, so let's get through this ring. We did pretty nicely. This one's easy enough. Okay, I'm just calm down because it's easy for me to do stuff like that. Oh no! Okay, so I believe if I had... Oh, I almost hit that. I almost hit it. Okay, apparently if you hit a loser space, you get 10 rupees. Interesting, so if you actually only have a times 1 multiplier, then it's actually better than landing on the green, at least. Huh. It's interesting that your, like, highest probabilities are kind of spread out. But yeah, that was pretty close, we almost got it. So I'm starting to judge it a little bit better. Which is good news. This is just not the... Like, it's a fine game. And it's not even the motion controls, again, that are messing me up. It's the, in that case, it kind of was. Oh, no. It's really just the whole, like, game in and of itself. Okay, yeah, it's definitely slowing down every ring. Okay, so I believe if I aim right here... Oh! Every single time! Oh... I'm always slightly off. Okay, but that's good. My eyes are definitely getting better at judging it. Now let's start actually making rupees back. Because if I can start doing that and I keep on landing on like the 20 rupee space with a times 10 multiplier, then we'll be good. Then I earn rupees really quickly that way, and then I can start continuing on. But if I run a rupee out of rupees for now, then that's okay too. Let's come back when I have more. Alright, so let's slowly ease our way into that. Same with this. That. So far, I think this is our best one. My overall movement is just the steadiest. Oh, right. Okay, let's just dive bomb off the edge. And coincidentally, I almost land right on the enemy cannon. On either side of it.
No!
Okay. Oh no, he takes another 10 rupees. Oh, I did not realize that. That makes sense now. So in other words, you lose 30 rupees if you land on that. Okay, that makes more sense. That makes way more sense. So don't land on those. Just not recommended. Okay, but that was still better. Like, we hit a balloon, but we still got through more rings there than I think in almost every other. So let's. No! Let's get a times 6. Okay. And then, you know what? That's another 30 rubies, so that's something. Yeah, that's the best we've done so far. So basically, we made up what we lost last time, sort of. Why is this so annoying?
Yes!
This is why I never completed it before, though. It's not an easy game to win. But if we do this one attempt at a time, then we'll slowly make our way there. It's just not easy. Okay, so let's head. So let's at least try to get that, which I think we can do if we just dive bomb right. Okay, not even close. But we got 5 rupees. And we have an opportunity for, I think, one more game. Yeah, one more game. Unless I get another 5 rupees. In which case, we have a chance for 2. This is not going well. Yeah. See, he's talking about landing on the 50 rupee space and going through all 5 rings and not hitting any of the balloons things. So that's how we get the heart piece, for sure. Okay, and up we go again. Okay. So let's go. Let's just go through here. Perfect. Through here. Through there. Okay. Aim more for not hitting them than hitting them. That's kind of more of the important part. Awesome. Okay. I believe if we wait right here, we're not gonna win. And we just lost. Big time. Alright, so that didn't work out. Okay, so since that disappointment just happened, I'm gonna have to come back and do that again later on. Once I have some more rupees and I have enough to really just blow on this game. Then we'll come back and we'll complete it. For now, we need to go back to Lanayru Desert. We're going to finish off this quest before we're done, and we'll leave off just before the boss fight. So we'll do the boss rush next time. Will be the focus of the next episode. That and probably that game, unless the boss rush takes the entire episode, which, to be honest, is very possible. It's a difficult challenge. That game is really annoying, and it's a little too random for my taste. So actually, I might complete that off-screen, depending on where my time is for an episode. Not right now, because I need to go to bed, because it's really late here, once again. but when I have an opportunity to do so, I will do that minigame without you having to watch it. And yeah, it'll probably be easier for me to do when I'm not doing commentary anyway. So I just feel like that's the most logical thing for me to do at the moment. Anyway, Scrapper's free now, so we can do this. This really simple and yet really important thing, which is really cool. So this tree here is oops, that's not what I meant to do. This tree over here is actually what bears the fruit that we need to cure the dragon, but it's dead, right? Well, that's actually an easily solved issue because there is a time shift stone right next to it. So problem solved. Sort of. Oh, actually, I don't think we did need Scrapper. Well then. What are you doing with that seedling, Vroom? Master Thunder Dragon needs fruit from the Tree of Life to recover. Unless you mean to help our master. Berserk, of course. Like, seriously, of course. Really, Vroom? Thank you, Zert. Make sure you plant the seedling somewhere, I'll be sure to thrive. Fooweep? I fear growing the seedling to maturity in Lanayru province is impossible. Berserk, we're counting on you. Weep! Okay. So here's the last goddess keep of probably the entire game. So yay! Complete! I think. I hope. Just to be sure. Yep. Last goddess cube. We're done. No more goddess cubes left. So, we're done that side quest. Which is awesome. I don't think I've ever completed that one before. In fact, I know I've never completed that one before. So let's keep on moving then. So we have the seedling, and we're going to need to hit that time shift stone to continue. Then yeah, we're pretty much done now. So yeah, let's head back up to the sky. And we kind of have already had hinted at this. If you remember, Groose wanted to grow something in the Sealed Temple. He wanted something to kind of liven up the place a little bit. And this seems like the perfect thing to do exactly that. Now, the thing is that regardless of all that, it's still seedling. Although it doesn't make sense if you take it. Like, technically, once you go outside of the time thing, it should grow back into a tree based on mechanics, but... Again, the fact that Hylia watches over Link in this makes time traveling stuff really confusing. Because there's something protecting him from being affected by the time shift stones in general. Because I don't think the time shift stones were actually used to really like shift time in that way. Because if they did, then you would be able to see the past but maybe not enter it. Because once you enter that field, you wouldn't be able to interact with it unless they were also able to exit into the past as well. But the thing is that when it's activated in both the, I guess it must be both in the past and the future, then something connects to it, but Link should be affected by it as well. Because things that leave the barrier die immediately, and things that were there before become old again. So Link himself shouldn't be able to exist in that time, but something is protecting him from doing that. It's probably the same thing that's preventing the sequel. And I know I'm thinking way too much about this, but I kind of like thinking about way too much about these things. So we'll go behind the hill of the Sealed Temple. We can do the Goddess Wall quest, or continue it anyway, because we're almost done. We've already done rupees and we've done arrows. So bombs and Fairies, I believe, are the only ones that are left. Maybe hearts as well. But we'll see in a minute. Let's see what he wants next. Life's crimson vessel. Ye who longs for the source of life, draw this shape so that it may be known. Do so, and from the heavens shall fall a rain of life's essence. Huh, what is written there? Does that mean anything to you? Okay, he wants hearts. So let's draw a heart, which I am awful at drawing, but you know. That's hopefully good enough. Yep, that's good enough. Astonishing! So that's what the ancient writing meant by crimson vessel. Let me give you a little token of my appreciation for assisting with my research. Okay, now he's just giving us forging materials. Perfect, I guess. Okay. Well, anyway, I'm not incredibly worried about that because we don't have to return to him. So let's head in here. And then, yeah. Okay, so what we want to do is really cool. Is we actually want to go through the Gate of Time so that we can plant a seed in the past so it can grow in the future and thrive. We need to plant it here because it's not possible for it to thrive in the linear region. And there are no time shift stones here, so in any other places except there, so I mean, we can't exactly do that. And hi, Impa. I'm just here to drop something off. Plant. And now we head back to the future. Or the present. This is the past. We are from the present, so we must assume that this is the past and the future is the future. Which is actually really interesting stuff. In all honesty, the topic I'm going to talk about in Child of Light, I could also talk about for this game. But this game I have another topic in mind for. And we're going to have fun with it. But yeah, there we go. Yo. So, I mean, there's a random tree that popped up, so. Oh yeah, now this is a tree I could look at all day. It's like a symbol of this temple or something. Every time I stare at it, my jaw starts hanging open and I get this weird happy feeling. Okay. Give me the fruit. You got the life fruit root. Eating this succulent fruit of legend cures any illness. Take it to the Thunder Dragon. Sure, let's go take it to the Thunder Dragon and learn the last part of the song. We are... Honestly, I could probably finish this game in 2 episodes. From now, it'll be just done. Like, easily 2 episodes I could get this done. But we still have a couple side quests left, a couple minigames left. And I'm hoping that we can get them all done in the next episode. If we can, then we'll actually be done this entire thing by episode 30. Which is interesting. It would be nice to have an even number ending for the series. Yeah, I know. It will be restored. So yeah. We'll see. It's not going to go very far past 30. I was honestly expecting 60 episodes. And that was based off of average completion times. But now I'm realizing those completion times were based off of completing hero mode as well. As regular mode. So yeah, I can do that on my own time. I've already mostly completed hero mode anyway, so we'll go back and finish that. I know this is the completion corner, and I've talked about this before, but I should mention it here again. When there's extra modes and harder versions, I might play it in my spare time, and I'm not going to complete it here. What I mean when I say that I'm going to complete a game is I mean I'm going to complete it in the original mode, and that's it. That's all I can really do here because you don't want to watch me play like it twice anyway. At least not right now. I mean, if I'm still here like a few years from now, maybe I will play this in here. And you know, technology might be better. We might have Skyward Sword HD, which I'll probably play here if that ever comes out. And it very well might. Tap. And if it does, you know what? I'll make the promise right now. I will play it on the channel. I will not make it a completion corner video, unless, no, even if there's, but I'll play it on the channel, I'll show it off, and I'll do like a quick run of it just to kind of show, stuff, but I won't be going for, a completion run like I am. So, yeah. Let's just hurry down and finish this part. Alright. Linear Gorge. Yes, let's land. So we're gonna go give him the fruit, and then we'll be done. So, hi there. Oh, Tip. Hello there. Is there something you need? Makes you wonder how in the world did he carry that in his pocket? Oh, is that what I think it is? You brought that here for me, didn't you? Whoa! Down the hatch! Zinga ding ding! Oh, you've done it, boy. I can feel the fruit's effect surging through me. It's exhilarating. I feel like a proper dragon again. Alright. Just because I have eternal life doesn't mean I can't get mighty sick. Thanks to you, boy, this old dragon will keep on charging a while yet. So in other words, he wasn't actually dead, which explains the fact that there was, like, light in the skull's eyes. He was just decayed. I owe you a big thank you, so allow me to perform a moving rendition of my part of the Song of the Hero. I should warn you, I've got a mean set of pipes, and I know how to use them. This will clear out those ears, boy, so brace yourself. Music is another thing that's always been important in all of the 3D Zelda games. Music and time travel. So I'm curious to see how that's played in Breath of the Wild. You learned part of the Song of the Hero. Cool. You! Tip, I owe you my life. You have to let me repay you. Give me some time to prepare, and when you next return to visit me, I believe you'll be mighty pleased. Well done, Master. You've successfully collected three parts of the Song of the Hero. I recommend you return to the sky and meet with the great sky spirit, Levias, to complete the song. No, we're gonna do other things first. We have lots of stuff left to do. Okay, now I have enough to play that game again. But that's not gonna be the focus for a little bit. In fact, I'll probably do most of the other stuff before I do that. It'll probably be after the next episode, however long that may take. So we'll be doing that. So the next episode will be focused on doing the boss rush. I think it can only be accessed in the future. And of course, because I have cured him, he should now be alive in the future, as we will see in just a moment. Wait, seriously? He's just not around anymore? Where is he? Hello, dragon! Okay. Alright. So he's only here in the past. I was wrong about that part. And they put a stool here just in case you need to recharge. Which is kind of nice. Because you'll probably have to recharge. Alright. Let's do that. Okay, so next time it's boss rush. Look forward to it. So thank you all for watching. I hope you liked the video. Either way, I encourage you to leave constructive criticism in the comments, as it helps to improve the quality of my videos and hopefully also quality of your enjoyment. If you wish to see more of my content, I'm going to leave a link to the previous episode, the next episode. I'm going to leave the channel icon in the center so you can subscribe to my channel for further notifications on my content. So thank you again, have a great day, and I'll see all of you very, very soon.